From the stage of the Grand Ole Opry House in Nashville, Tennessee, the country music capital of the world, Decca Records is proud to present the Grand Ole Opry with Ernest Tubb, Bill Anderson, Margie Bowles, the Osborne Brothers, Jimmy Newman, Grandpa Jones, Loretta Lynn, the Wilburn Brothers, Bill Monroe, the Glaser Brothers, the Texas Troubadours, Tommy Jackson, and yours truly, Bill Claiborne. That was Tommy Jackson and his fiddle with a typical tune heard quite often here on the Grand Ole Opry stage on Saturday night, an old tune called Uncle Joe. Thank you very much, Tommy, and don't you go away because we'll be calling on you a little later on. Friends, our first guest tonight here on the Grand Ole Opry, the big tall Texan and the head man of the Texas Troubadours, let's make welcome Mr. Ernest Tubb.
Thank you very much. And Troubadours, I'm going to need a little help here. Cal Smith, if you'll get Jack Green and Leon Rhodes over here, let's do one that some of the folks have asked for called Do What You Do, Do Well.
He couldn't move a mountain nor pull down a big oak tree, but my daddy became a mighty big man with the simple philosophy.
Do what you do, do well, boy. Do what you do, do well.
Give your love and all of your heart and
do what you do, do well.
Oh, buddy. Sometimes he'd kiss my mother and hold her tenderly. Then he'd look across the top of her head. Then he'd wink and say to me,
do what you do, do well, boy. Do what you do, do well.
Give your love and all of your heart. A man of laughter, but a tragedy came by. The tears ran free and he'd say to me, never be afraid to cry.
And do what you do, do well, boy. Do what you do, do well.
Give your love and all of your heart. About a mighty big man with a mighty big heart and a mighty few words to say.
Do what you do, do well, boy. Do what you do, do well.
Give your love and all of your heart and
do what you do, do well.
And do what you do, do well.
Real good advice for all of us. Do what you do, do well. Thank you very much, Ernest.
You're more than welcome, and I want to thank all the Troubadours for helping me out there. What do we got coming up next, Bill?
Well, Ernest, our next guest tonight is a great songwriter, a great singer, and as you will all agree, just a great guy. Mr. Sincerity, Bill Anderson.
Thank you. Thank you very much. It's always nice to be with you down at the Grand Ole Opry. We'd like to reach back and do one of our older songs for you tonight. We can get all the po' boys to help us out. The story of an old boy that got into a little trouble one time is called Dead or Alive.
They're all begging me come home, but I won't budge. Important folks are waiting there to see me, like the sheriff and the jailer and the judge. My picture's on the front page of the paper. I'm the local boy who wandered off alone. Now they want me back so bad they're giving money to the first man who'll come out and bring me home.
Dead or alive, dead or alive.
$10,000.
Dead or alive.
One night last week I got a little reckless, and I couldn't hold my trigger finger still. The barrel pointed at the county marshal, but I only meant to scare him, not to kill. Now the foothills of these mountains hold my secret. Only they know of this old deserted shack. But the chances are some bloodhound's gonna find me, and some other dirty dog will take me back.
Dead or alive, dead or alive.
I wonder if I'm better off. Always said that I'd amount to nothing, that to bury me would be a waste of earth. But if they'll just put my price upon my tombstone, then the world can see what I was really worth.
Dead or alive, dead or alive.
$10,000.
Wonderful number, Dead or Alive. And now, friends, from a talent contest in North Carolina just a few years ago to the world-famous Grand Ole Opry stage, one of Decca's top artists, Miss Margie Bowes.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Bill. I'd like to do one of my favorite songs that I have out on record. A song written by one of the Po' Boys, Jimmy Gately. It's called Overnight.
Didn't learn to love you like I love you overnight.
Overnight.
So I know that I just can't forget you overnight. How I wish it could be done. Just turn off a switch and run. But I found out it can't be done overnight.
Overnight.
I can act like I don't care and make it look so real. I can change the way I look,
but not the way I feel. How was I to know that I would lose you overnight and be trying somehow to forget you overnight?
Overnight.
But I found one thing is true. If I do stop loving you, it's something that I won't do overnight.
Overnight.
Oh, how I wish it could be done. Just turn off switch and run. But I found out it can't be done overnight.
gentlemen, that was Miss Margie Bowles. Our next group tonight on the stage of the Grand Ole Opry is one of the finest bluegrass teams of our time. Now let's make welcome Sonny and Bobby, the Osborne Brothers.
Thank you. Thank you, Bill. It's always a great pleasure for us to step on the stage of the Grand Ole Opry. We have an old one picked out tonight for you. Sonny, if you will, let's do one called The Salty Dog Blues.
Salty Dog Blues. Friends, this next star tonight hails from deep in the state of Louisiana. The Alligator Man, he calls himself. Let's make welcome Jimmy Newman.
Hey! Thank you, Bill, and it's nice to be on the show. I have sort of a different type tune for the show right now, and it's called Bayou Talk.
Records and the radio.
Everybody talking that bio talk.
Now this is the story of an old boy I met down in Louisiana while hunting alligators. He was the funniest guy I'd ever met with his bio talk, and he sounded something like this. Said, I got one of my good cousins, and boy, he liked to get high on that alligator milk, yeah. Said, one time he gets so drunk, he pick up a snake and try to kill a stick with it. In other words, he's under the alcafluence of alcohol. Said he'd get arrested so many times for drunk driving. One time he was crossing the street on foot. The police tried to arrest him for reckless walking and attempt to crawl.
Bio talk, bio talk. Everybody talking that bio talk.
Phonographic records and the radio.
Everybody talking that bio talk.
One time, my good friend, Romancy Bordeaux, take a trip up north, way up north to Shreveport. Said he was unclimbing one of them deep hills with his automobile, and he he turned that thing over about 8 or 7 times right down that hill. But old man crawled himself out of that car, staggered himself around, and he take about 4 or 3 steps. Policeman walked up to him and he said, "Hey, boy, you drunk?" But old man said, "Heck yeah, you don't think I'm one of them reckless drivers, eh?"
By your talk, by your talk, everybody talking that by your talk.
Phonograph records and the radio,
everybody talking that by your talk.
Said one time my uncle so Stan, he brought himself up one of them one-way streets, and the police stopped him and he said, "Hey, boy, where in the world do you think you're going?" Uncle So Stan said, "I don't know, but I must be late. Everybody's coming back." Police say, "Well, didn't you see them arrows back there?" Uncle So Stan said, "Arrows? Man, I don't even see the Indian."
By your talk, by your talk, everybody talking that by your talk.
Phonograph records and the radio,
everybody talking that by your talk.
Ladies and gentlemen, Jimmy C. Newman from Louisiana, the Alligator Man. And now here on the stage of the Grand Ole Opry tonight, the Grand Ole Man of the Mountains, Grandpa Jones, to sing 8 More Miles to Louisville.
I've traveled over this country wide, seeking fortune fair. Up and down the two coastlines, I've traveled everywhere. From Portland east to Portland west and back along the line. Going out to the place that's best, that old hometown of mine. 8 more miles into Louisville will come into my view. 8 more miles on this old road and I'll never more be blue. I knew someday that I'd come back, I knew it from the start. 8 more miles to Louisville, the hometown of my heart. She's long and she is tall, but she's the kind that you can't find rambling through the land. I'm on my way this very day to win her heart and hand. Oh, 8 more miles in Louisville will come into my view. 8 more miles on this old road and I'll never more be blue. I knew someday that I'd come back, I knew it from the start. 8 more miles from Louisville, the hometown of my heart. In them bluegrass hills, where gently flows the Ohio, my place called Louisville. Oh, 8 more miles into Louisville will come into my view. 8 more miles on this old road and I'll never more be blue. I knew someday that I'd come back, I knew it from the start. 8 more miles from Louisville, the hometown of my heart.
Now, on with the show. We're listening to part 2 of the Grand Ole Opry Time, brought to you by Decca Records. And here comes one of our favorite gals. It's a young lady that's always a pleasure to introduce on any stage. Let's give a big Nashville welcome to Miss Loretta Lynn.
Thank you very much, Bill. It always makes me feel real good to get a nice introduction like that. The song that I'd like to do right now was a great big hit. The only bad thing about it, it wasn't mine. So I'm gonna do it anyway. It's called Act Naturally.
They'll make a film about a girl who's sad and lonely. Well, I bet you I'm gonna be a big star. Might win an Oscar, you can't never tell. The movies are gonna make me a big star, 'cause I can play the part so well. I hope you come to see me in the movies, then I know that you will plainly see the biggest fool that's ever hit the big time. And all I gotta do is act naturally.
Favorite female artist. And now, next on the stage of the Grand Ole Opry tonight, two young men who are loved and admired by millions each week. Let's give a big hand for Teddy and Doyle, the Wilburn Brothers.
Thank you, Bill. And thanks to all you nice folks visiting here at the Opry House tonight.
Teddy, if you could sing just half as good as that Loretta Lynn, I'd make a fortune.
I could say the same thing to you, though. I hope we never have to follow her again, though.
I do, too. Let's do a song.
Okay.
I'll take what's left of me and move along.
You took the most of me when you left. The biggest part of me was yourself. You took my heart with you, and now my mind is gone. So I'll take what's left of me and move along. Now my friends will know that I'm a fool, because you took my pride along with you. I lost the dreams I had, my chance for you is gone. So I'll take what's left of me and move along. I'll take what's left of me if you don't mind, and get used to being without those things of mine. I'll take what's left of me and move along, if this little bit of me can make it on its own. You took my happiness away with you, and now I've lost the faith that I had to. I lost my world today, my feelings are all gone. So I'll take what's left of me and move along. I'll take what's left of me and move along.
Thank you, Teddy and Doyle. Those were two of the finest young men in country music today, ladies and gentlemen, and two that we're mighty proud of here on the Grand Ole Opry. And now from the bluegrass state of Kentucky, here's the king of bluegrass music, Bill Monroe and the Bluegrass Boys, with Mary at the Home Place.
When I left the state of Georgia, just an old great mule to ride, headed far, wide open spaces, for a fortune to abide. Left my Mary on the home place, her eyes was blurred with silent tears. Told her to wait, I'd find the gold mine and return in just a year. Many days I searched for fortune, so someday she'd be my wife. Then I struck it rich in Texas and found the better things of life. Then one day I met a stranger as the dealt the cards around. It came to be he was the brother I'm Mary in the old hometown. He said she vowed to never marry, for her love for me was strong, and that she would still be waiting when I returned to her back home. I gave my fortune to a poor boy with clothes of rags up on his back, to spend my life back in Georgia with Mary in a country shack.
Thank you very much, Bill Monroe, the king of bluegrass. Well, friends, we're fortunate tonight to have on the stage of the Grand Ole Opry one of the finest harmony groups in country music. And we're speaking about the Glaser Brothers.
Well, thank you, Bill. Thank you very much. We've got a song here that's about a guy that's got a big problem. He's got a jukebox in his ear. So, Chuck and Jim, if you'll gather around here, we'll do this song called A Girl Like You.
There's a jukebox in my ear, playing so loud I can hardly hear, and it's telling a story about a girl like you. And each selection that I make tells me how my heart will break for falling in love with a girl like you. Well, it's just an old without a heart, but oh so mean, says I'll probably spend my whole life feeling blue. So I'll just put in one more dime and play the same song one more time, 'cause I wanna hear about a girl like you. I'll probably spend my whole life feeling blue. always dream about a girl like you.
Those were the Gracie Brothers, featuring Tom Paul. And now here on the stage of the Grand Ole Opry tonight...
Bill Claiborne.
Yes.
How come it is that Teddy and I have been associated with Grand Ole Opry for so long and you don't ever give us an opportunity to introduce anybody?
I just did.
Did?
Tonight. Right now.
Tonight. Well, wonderful. I'll tell you what, I got an idea here. Cal Smith, he's one of the Texas troubadours. In fact, he kind of helps Ernest keep them boys under control. Mm-hmm. And he's a pretty good music teacher along with it. I'm sure that... if he would get the Texas troubadours gathered around, we'd get a good instrumental out of him. How about that, Cal?
Sure will, Dawl, and thank you so much, you and Bill both. And the troubadours are here and raring and ready to go, so what do you say we turn them loose on a little instrumental tune here featuring Buddy Charlton and Leon Rhodes on the all-time great Panhandle Rag.
Panhandle Rag, done for you by the Texas Troubadours.
Hey, Bill.
And I know, Teddy, you're on equal time, I'll bet.
I gotta have equal time. I mean, Doyle can't star on my show.
Well, we have to keep peace in the family, all right.
Listen, I would like to introduce my favorite duet.
Who might that be, Teddy?
Bill, that to me would be two of my favorite people, Ernest Tubb and Loretta Lynn. And give it up.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Bill, and thank you, Teddy. How are you, Loretta, honey?
I'm just fine, Ernest. How are you doing?
Pretty good. Isn't this a nice audience tonight?
It sure is.
Hey, let's do that thing called Keep Those Cards and Letters Coming In.
Let her go.
Leon?
Didn't want to be no soldier, didn't want to leave your side, didn't want to cross that ocean, it's so deep and wide. I guess that I'm the bluest soldier in old Germany, but though I'm blue, I'm gonna be true if you'll just write to me. You gotta keep those cards and letters coming in, honey. Say you love me time and time again, honey. It's a many a mile from Nashville to Berlin, honey. So keep those cards and letters coming in.
Oh, that's right, Leon.
Loretta, you gonna keep writing me, honey?
You tell me that my letters cheer you, keep my loving on your mind, keeps your heart from ever thinking about those sweet frolics. Well,
Berlin, honey. So keep those cards and letters coming in. So keep those cards and letters coming in.
Thank you, Loretta. Thank you, too, Ernest. You know, neighbors, that's some real good advice. So until next Saturday night, how about doing just that? Keep those cards and letters coming in. And now here's Tommy Jackson closing out the show tonight with an old fiddle tune called Daisy Jones.